So in the last session, we have seen about the application of shift registers. In today's class, we will be seeing about the counters. So from the name itself, it is evident that it is nothing but you are going to use a set of flip-flops. It is going to count the sequence of input pulses in the digital waveform. Okay, so how many pulses are there, whether 4 pulses or 8 pulses or 16 pulses are there, it is just used to count the sequence of the flip-flops, count the number of the states using the flip-flops. Okay, so in this counters are broadly classified into two types. One is your synchronous counter, another is your asynchronous counter. When I say it as synchronous counter, that means I am going to synchronously give the clock pulse to all the flip-flops. Here I have just taken a 2-bit synchronous counter, so 2 flip-flops I have used. When I use 2 flip-flops, 2 power n, 4 states are going to be used. So this 4 states, this states is called as the modulus. Okay. So, how I am going to give the circuit configuration? Just put 2 flip-flops, J0, K0, J1, K1, Q and you have drawn. Now, what I am going to do? I am going to give the logic high to the first flip-flop. Okay. Then, I am going to give the clock pulse synchronously. Okay. Whenever I am going to give the clock pulse synchronously to both the flip-flops, it is called as a synchronous counter. Okay, so whereas whenever you are going to move in for your asynchronous counter, in this case, the first condition is draw the flip-flop, give the logic 1 to both the flip-flops. Here the way you give your clock signal differs. Output of the first flip-flop will be fed as the clock signal for the second one or for the succeeding flip-flops. Initial flip-flop will be given a separate clock, and after that, if you could see, all the succeeding flip-flops, the output of the first flip-flop will be the clock pulse for the second flip-flop. Okay, so when you are going to consider, so this will require minimum propagation delay because all flip-flops are going to be clicked at the same time. Whereas here, the output, only when the output is ready, then only after some time delay of nanoseconds, it can reach the second flip-flop. So, there will be more propagation delay in case of your asynchronous counter. Okay, and here this asynchronous counter is also called as your ripple counter. So, you would have seen the ripples in the water, 1010, okay. The same way when the data comes in as output, after some time delay only, it reaches the next stage. So, it is called as ripple counter, where you will be seeing the propagation delay, okay. So, the only the difference you should know, asynchronous and synchronous. Synchronous means all the flip-flops are going to be given synchronously the signal to each and every flip-flop, whereas here, first flip-flop will be given the clock signal separate, and after that, if you could see, the output of the first one will be clock pulse for the second one and so on. Okay. So, now we will go and analyze the asynchronous or your ripple counters. Okay. So, I have just taken a 2-bit counter. I told you 2 bits means 2 power n, 4 states. So, modulus is 4. It is a mod 4 counter also, you can say. So, the number of states specifies the modulus. Suppose if it is going to be 2 power 3, then it will be counting 8 states from 0 to 7. So, it is a mod 8 counter. So, from 0 to 7, 8 states it counts. Okay. So, now we will see the working of it and analyze its timing diagram. Okay. So, now what I am going to give? I am going to give 4 clock pulses. So, I have drawn the clock waveform. Then, so this is going to be my clock and this is going to be my Q0 and this is going to be my Q1. Okay. Now, what happens whenever I am going to give 1-1 to both the flip-flops? What is the condition? 1-1 condition in JK flip-flop means it is a toggle condition. It will toggle to 0 to 1, 0 and 1. It will be switching to its opposite state, right? Now, whenever I am going to give 1-1, okay? So, initially the flip-flop will be reset. So, it will be in the 0 state, okay? What I am giving? I am giving a negative edge triggering. So, it will trigger only during the negative edge, okay? Now, so whenever it reaches the negative edge, the initial data which is stored in your output of your counter, it is going to be in both the flip-flops, it is going to be 0, 0. So, just draw these lines. I am going to apply the first clock pulse. What will happen in that case? So this toggle condition 0 was there earlier, it will switch to 1. Okay, so initially it was 0, now what will happen? It will switch to 1 and this 0 will come out. So only whenever I am giving 0, the Q naught output, it switches to 1. It switches to 0, 1, 0, 1 for every clock pulse, whereas your Q1 switches to 0, 1 for every 2 clock pulses. Okay, I will say the reason why. Because whenever I am given the 1 to both the flip-flops, so both the flip-flops are going to be in the toggle state. Whenever I am going to give the first clock pulse, when it reaches the negative edge, whenever I am going to give, it is going to change from 0 to 1. But at that time, this value remains at 0. Why? Because it is also going to be a negative edge triggered flip-flop. When this 0 changes to 1, this 0 comes out and this 1 retains at this. Now, this 0 goes here. So, when this 0 goes here, it is a NOT gate. That is a negative edge triggering. It will go 1. Whenever I am going to give 1, this flip-flop will not work. It will work only when it gets 0, it will get triggered. So, whenever it is going to be 0 here, it will be 1. So, this part will not be triggered at all. It will remain at the same position. Now, we will apply the second clock pulse. Now, what will happen? So, this 1 will change to 0 and whatever the 1 which is there, it comes here. Okay. So, now in this case 1, it changes to 0 in the first flip-flop. Now, this 1 comes here. If 1 comes here, what will happen? Here you have an inverter, so it becomes 0. At this stage, this flip-flop will start working or it will work at the negative edge triggering. So, at this point, when it reaches the second clock pulse, this will be turned on. It will be at 1. Now, apply the next clock pulse, what happens? This 0 will be changed to 1. So, when this is changed to 1, this will be at 0. When this 0 comes here, it will be 1, it will not work. So, this flip-flop will remain in the same state. And after that, it switches to 0. And the same condition repeats. So, is this clear? Both will be at 0 level. Whenever I am going to give 1, so this is going to get triggered, whereas this will take the previous pulse and remain in the same state. Whenever I am going to apply the next clock pulse, when this 1 goes, this will become 0 and it will get triggered. In other words, the first flip-flop toggle for every clock pulse and the second flip-flop toggles for every 2 clock pulses. So, if you want, you can see how it counts the 4 states 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, and after that it resets to 0. So, it can count up to 4 bits 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So, all these 4 states it can count. So, it is called as a mod 4 counter, or you can say it as a 2 bit asynchronous counter. Now, the same counter, I am going to extend it for the 3 bit and the 4 bit. How I can extend it for the 3 bit? Add one more circuitry here. How to add? Here, I am going to add one more circuitry. This is going to be J2, K2 and Q2. How to add now? So, here, first point what you should do, the clock of the first one should be given as a clock for the second one. Now, what is the next step I should do? So, I am going to add, one minute, whenever I am drawing, the connection should be clear enough. Okay, what I have done? The output of the previous flip-flop is fed as a clock for the second flip-flop and you give a logic high. Okay, now how sure will be your timing diagram will differ? So, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So, once you can know the logic, you can design it or draw it for any counter. So, now how it will go? Okay. Now, if I'm going to consider as a 3-bit counter, what will happen? The first flip flop will toggle for every clock pulse, and the second flip flop will toggle for every 2 clock pulse. And whenever I'm going to have a 3-bit counter, it is 2^3, so it can count the states, 8 states or 8 mod 8 counter, I can say, which counts from 0 to 7. So it is going to count from 0 to 7. So 0 to 111, it is going to count. Whenever I am going to draw the timing diagram, I have to draw. So it is going to count for each waveform, and the second one is going to change itself for every 2 clock pulses, and the next third one is going to count for every 4 clock pulses. Now you can see how it can count the digits. If you see 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, 111. So it counts the states, 8 states it counts. Okay. So you should know here, just like this, you can draw it for a 2-bit or a 3-bit or a 4-bit counter. Okay. So now you should know here. See, whenever you are going to have, that is when both the inputs at this place, when both the inputs at this place is 1, that is at the end of the 4th clock pulse is 1, then it triggers off the next one. In the previous case, if you could see, whenever you are here, you are going to have 1, it triggers. So in this case, when it comes, when both the inputs in the previous state are 1, then it triggers to the next state. Now the same thing, we can extend it for the 4-bit counter also. So if I am going to go to 4-bit, what is the, how much is the thing? So 2^4 is 16. So I can count the states from 0 to 15. Now how I can draw the diagram? One more diagram I have to draw, that's all. So put a flip-flop J3, K3 and Q3. First of all, this Q2 should be given as a clock pulse for the second one. And what is the modification? Here I have to give it to the other counter. When you are drawing, please draw the clock pulse, and this should not merge, that's all. Over. So now how will you draw your waveform? So whenever I want to draw the waveform, I am just up to 16. Okay, you can extend it. So up till 16 you can extend it. So now what happens? You should have one more Q3. So how it will be? It will be staying at 0 till 8, and after 8 it will stay at 1. Till 8, then it will stay at 1. So then how it will be counting? So 0 0 0 0 it is 0 0 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 0 2, like that it goes on. So it goes on till your 0111 is 7, and after that it becomes, whenever it comes here, what happens? After that it becomes, sorry, here it is written 10008, then 100. So like that, when it is till this, it remains at 01000. After that it just prolongs. So till 15 you will be having the value. Okay, again it becomes 1. So it is becomes 1001. Then 9, 10, 11, 12 till 15. So it is able to count the values from 0 to 15. Now in the same thing, I am going to convert this to a mod 10 counter. Before moving on to this mod 10 counter, we will just see in your asynchronous or ripple counters, there exists a propagation delay. Suppose if I am going to consider a 3-bit counter alone. Okay, if I am going to consider a 3-bit counter alone, saying for every flip-flop, I am having a delay of 10 seconds. So for the 3 flip-flops, I will be having 30 nanoseconds delay. So in that case, the clock frequency of the entire circuit, it should be of 33.33 megahertz. So this is the way to calculate your propagation delay. Okay, now we will see one more counter in it, that is the mod 10 counter. So now here, what you are going to do is that, So when I say it is going to be a mod 10 counter, I can say it as a mod 10 counter, or for the 10 I can call it as a decayed asynchronous counter. Okay, so here what am I going to do is a small modification, so you can change the design of your counters. Okay, now when I say it as a, I told you this is the condition you should remember, 2 power n is greater than or equal to n. Suppose if I am going to, I have to count the 10 states, that is I should count the states from 0 to 9. In this case, how many flip-flops are required? Suppose if I put 3 flip-flops, 2 power 3 is only 8 states, but I want to count for 10 states. So 2 power 4, it is greater than or equal to, so 2 power 4 is how much? So whenever I am going to use 4 flip-flops, okay, so you will be getting 16 states I can count, but what is the required state is 10. So I have to use 4 flip-flops I can use. Okay, so now my states are only 10. So now the states which can be counted with 4 number of flip-flops is 16 states. So in that case, I can go in for the number of flip-flops. First of all, I should design, think of how many flip-flops I need. Okay, I cannot use 3 flip-flops, so I go in for my 4 flip-flops. Now what is the condition? It should count till 9. After that, it should get, when it reaches 10, it should reset. So I am going to use a control logic for this too, that's all. Okay, so when I am going to get 1010, in that case what I am going to do, I am just going to take the output of my J1 and I am going to take the output of my J3. I am going to give it to a NOT gate. What will happen? Till 9 it should count, after that it should reset to 0. So these 0 0 I have taken. Whenever I am going to take this 0 0, when it goes to AND gate it becomes 0, when it goes to the NAND gate it becomes 1. Now this, what I am going to give is, I am going to give it to the, I am going to add a clear signal, that means it will count till 9. So 8 is there, one more I will put. This is 1000. Okay, so it remains at 1. So 1010. One more waveform, sorry. Here one waveform is there, 1001. Okay, so 1001 is 9. After that, when it comes to the 10th, it should recycle to 0. So what I am going to, I am just putting an AND gate. So when, wherever the 0 is there, it changes to 1. When this 1 it is going to give, it is going to clear. 1 means when I use a NOT gate, it clears the flip-flop 0. So after 9, when I want to enter the 10, it clears the flip-flop. So if I want to use a truncated sequence, usually if you could see, a 4-bit counter means it will count from 0 to 15. But as per my application, if I want to use it as a mod 10 counter, okay, or any truncated sequence, then you can just put a AND gate in the place of wherever it becomes 0, and then you can give a clear signal so that this 1 will go, 1 will come here and this will go as 0 and clears and resets the flip-flop. So thus it will count only from 0 to 9, after that it resets the flip-flop. So with this I conclude. Okay, so now in this section we have seen what is counter, what are its classification, then how to draw the 2-bit, 3-bit, 4-bit asynchronous counter, as well as a truncated sequence of mod 10 or decayed counter. Okay, so with this I conclude. Thank you. In the next session we will be seeing about the synchronous counters. Thank you.